Two, testing one, two.
Where exactly are these vaults? You know, I always hear record people say, it's in the vault. I mean, you must go buy other stuff to get to this stuff in the vault. Where exactly? Is it like behind the mayonnaise? I mean, where in the vault? I mean, you guys have been together how many years now?
22 or 23 years.
So at some point in those, you just pass by this stuff. There's other stuff. Where in the vault is this?
The vault, you take a left at the Fortress of Solitude.
Oh, I see.
Right, and the vault is the next door to the right.
I see.
And that's where Kiss keeps their stuff. We split the rent with Superman.
I see.
Well, we actually really save almost everything.
Yeah.
We're anal only in that way. We save every piece of Kistry we can get our hands on. Right. It includes fan memorabilia. So almost any live show that we've done, especially in the 70s, we have locked up in vaults.
So why now? At what point? Why not after 15 years? Why not after 8? Why not 30? Why not wait 6-7 years more? Why now?
I think you know, when we did the Unplugged thing for MTV, that was the first time the four of us have played together in well over 15 years. And I think when we realized the magic was still there, I thought everybody kind of figured maybe there was a shot at maybe putting the makeup back on and making it work again.
We really, you know, we separated and parted company in a haze of ego, drugs, alcohol, and all the other ills that go along with
it. And that would be a haze.
That is definitely a haze.
I mean, that really is. You know, any one of those is a haze on itself. And when you put them all together, that's piece of...
Well, it's very interesting because you have four people's perception of how it ended, and it's all very different, but... You know, we swore we would never do this again. Most of us said we had no interest in getting back together. But I think what we were really saying was we had no interest in getting back together if we were going to feel about each other the way we did when we split. But when we got together and did Unplugged, it really became apparent to us that everybody had grown. Everybody was straight, clear-headed. And actually, instead of recreating the past, we could pick up where we left off. And I think nowadays, more than ever, people are ready for entertainment.
Hey guys, it's Jeff here. Thanks for joining me today. Appreciate it. Today, yes, another Kiss-related video. One of my favorite kind of videos to do and talk about. It is another anniversary date that came up on one of their albums. This one from 1996. It is not a studio album, but when you say 1996, you kind of know that it is. The original lineup is going to be involved, and it was a lot of celebrating when they did get back together. You know, when was it going to happen after, you know, 15 years of not playing together? How was it all going to turn out? But yeah, it was a good time in 96. They started the reunion. They traveled, you know, worldwide, and in celebration of that, they wound up releasing You Wanted the Best, You Got the Best. Now, this is a compilation album, a compilation live album, I want to add. And you might say to yourself, well, what's the difference? Compilation live? Is it all live albums, a compilation of their songs? This album was actually put out in 96, and it actually has... the majority of the tracks are from their live album from 1975 and their second live album from 1977. They pretty much compiled them onto here. And there are actually saying there's four unreleased tracks on as well. It's a great album. I like it. Like I said, they are the masters of repackaging when it comes to reselling their old material. And this is the first and only live compilation that I have in the collection that they put out. The album went through pressings but never reissued back in 2014 when they redid all the other reissues. Unfortunately, if you were expecting to get it, there was a lot of sad and disappointed people because you were only able to get this album in the Kisteria box set. 1,000 pressings made for that, 180 gram vinyl. One of the exclusives that came in the box set. So you know, unfortunately, if you didn't have it and it's still available, but you're going to pay crazy money for it, you know, you're looking at a couple hundred dollars for a pressing that has been long out of press. Unless you start hitting eBay, which is, like I said, you know, you can get it from, you know, $200 to $500 what they're available, depending on if they're used, unopened. But yeah, June 25th marks this one, 26 years. You wanted the best, you got the best. You know, it's just a title given because of the Alive album and all the live compilations. And, you know, that's always the tag phrase at the beginning of their concerts. So, you know, it was pretty appropriate to name the album with that title, especially since they are all a compilation of their two live albums. And one side, which would be side four, is the Jay Leno interview. So that's it, guys. That was the whole update here for the anniversary, the 26 years since You Want It the Best, You Got the Best was put out in celebration for the original band members getting together and starting their tour worldwide. So take care, everybody. I'll talk to you guys soon.